Good evening. I'm Kill the Vid. I'm your host for the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Since I've beat, most recently, the main campaign of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, I realized that there are some additional stories and episodic content within the game. With that in mind, I'm about to debut a new episode focusing on dreadful crimes. This is going to be episode number 1. And if you haven't done so already, please like, follow, and subscribe to the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel for more Let's Play gaming livestream walkthroughs for such games as Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Mad Max, Sleeping Dogs, and many others. So, grab a snack, grab a drink, grab what you need. It's time for Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate, right now on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Here we go. Get a visual. Bear with me. Okay, let's fix this up. That had to do this live. So let's continue, shall we? Glasses on. Thank you. And by the way, there's another DLC. Actually, there's about two of them for Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Two additional ones, The Last Madaraja and Jack the Ripper. Now I just need to briefly restart the game. Okay, it's restarting. Little technical mishap, but it is what it is. Wait till we get a visual. Sorry for the delay, folks. Just when I had things working before. Okay, finally. So, once again, I'm going to be live streaming the downloadable content for Assassin's Creed Syndicate, particularly the Dreadful Crimes DLC, which is already on the map. It's not like with Jack the Ripper, which you saw on the menu screen, where I access the DLC through the screen, but actually is going to be in-game. So I had to go to a certain destination on the map, a certain borough in London to start it off. I believe to start it off, there's going to be a magnifying glass on the map, and it's going to be part of the, as I said, part of the Dreadful Crimes DLC. And there are still the Queen Victoria missions. Those are my rooks.
Draw your weapons and fire!
No, it's not. Now I'm just gonna loot the body.
I'll find out where you're buried.
Yes.
Don't so new Christ.
No. Let's go on to the destination. So the destination on the map is actually right here in the district of Whitechapel. So, part of the Dreadful Crimes, it's called A Simple Matter of Murder. £1,000, 800 XP, the rewards are capes and country cloak.
If the police don't collect the body, the rats will.
Not looking so tough now, are ya?
So the character models, of course, are the same for both the Rooks and the Blighters.
Better you than me.
But when it comes to the Rooks, those are our class. There's about four or five classes. Body types. Obviously got the female members. You've got the Rook Riders.
Serves you right.
And then you have the Brawlers.
You! Over there! Stop it!
Uh-oh.
Watch where you're going.
That's the way.
The bobbies. Which of course are the constables. They all look like Mayor McCheese. that's what the traditional British police look like. You know, there are some variations to the uniform of British police officers. But I do like the old school, you know, with the helmets. Go. Or not the helmets, or the hats. Yeah. Gonna switch to the full screen. Solve the seemingly simple murder of a factory worker.
This is going very badly, isn't it?
It certainly doesn't have the makings of a ripping good novel.
What happened here?
Ah! The charming and delightful Frye Twins.
Have we met?
Mr. Raymond knows everyone. He knows everything about this city. He writes it all up in his books.
I'm Henry Raymond, writer of third-rate lurid stories, penny dreadfuls, if you will, and this is little Artie.
Mr. Raymond takes real murders and makes them so awfully exciting. The guilty always get caught.
There's one unfolding just here. Perhaps one of you would like to try your hand in solving it.
Tutorial: Dreadful Crimes. To find the murderer, use Eagle Vision to search the investigation zones for clues. Interrogate every suspect. Press menu button to enter the progression log and access your collected evidence. Accuse the guilty suspect to solve the case and collect your reward. Be careful though, as every false accusation will reduce the reward. Follow Raymond and Artie.
I do find crime so delightfully entertaining, don't you? I mean, solving crimes, of course. Finding a solution is exhilarating.
Speak to Mr. Freems. Mr. Freems, owner of the factory. Interrogating suspects. To interrogate a suspect, use left joystick to select a topic and press A to end the interrogation. Press B. So let's speak.
I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad duly with bloody hands. No one's been able to find the murder weapon and arrest the murderer. Could you sort it out quickly? It's holding up the work. They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
Inspect Wilkins' body. Let's find the body. Body's right over there. Time to put on my detective hat. Okay, there's the body. I guess this is somewhat similar to LA Noir. Warehouse, Wilkins' body. A deep stab wound to the chest. A bandana obscures the victim's face. All locations unlocked. You can now make an accusation or continue your investigation. Make accusations with care. So, case file. To access the case of evidence, please hit the menu button. So there's about two additional clues, so... I want to make sure I gather all any evidence. Okay, here's a knife. Presumably the murder weapon. Warehouse knife. Small white with the initials D coolly scratched into the handle.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
So that's two clues found. Still want to get all evidence. Buck's brother, Dooley. I don't want to accuse falsely, of course. Tone's shaking, so we better interrogate.
I was standing there, having a think, when a fella come at me and give me a thumping. Dooley tries to stop him, and he thrashes Dooley. I run out to find help. When I come back, the man's lying dead, and there's Dooley holding a knife. Please don't arrest him.
Dooley's holding a knife.
That's Dooley's knife, all right. He never lent it to nobody.
Let's go talk to Dooley. Bucks, bro.
brother.
He's my brother. He don't like to work hard, so one of the workers give him a thrashing. I tried to stop it, and he stops hitting Buck and starts hitting me. He knocks me to the ground and give me a kick. I find my work knife under me and grab it. I lift my hands to protect myself, and he knocks me out with a punch. Later on, I wakes up, and the man's lying there, dead. He knocks me to the ground and give me a kick. I find my work knife under me and grab it. I lift my hands to protect myself, and he knocks me out with a punch. Later on, I wakes up, and the man's lying there, dead.
Let's see if there's any more evidence. Let me see. It's like the progression log. Must be this button. Okay. Buck, Dooley's brother, body, claims he returned to find the man dead and Dooley holding the knife. Dooley claims he was suddenly accosted and beaten. His brother Dooley tried to stop the beating and was beaten in turn. Buck ran to find help. Help. Knife. Confirms that it's Dooley's knife. States that Dooley won't lend it to anyone. Dooley. Buck's brother. Body. Claims he was knocked to the ground. He found his knife and lifted it up. Then was knocked out by a punch from the victim, awakened to find the man dead. Buck identifies Buck as his brother. Dooley tries to stop a worker who was giving Buck a beating. The worker turned on Dooley. Mr. Frames, owner of the factory. Body. Claims he arrived to find Wilkins already dead and the body Dooley and the boy Dooley with bloody hands. Workers mentions that workers are rough and often fight with one another. Clues. Okay. So, see if there's any additional clues. Boy, I started accusing. I'm gonna ask the guy one more time. Mr. Frame.
They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other. I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to find the murder weapon and arrest the murderer. Could you sort it out quickly? It's holding up the work.
Okay.
Oh, there might be another clue.
That's Dooley's knife, all right. He never lent it to nobody. I was standing there, having a think, when a fella come at me and give me a thumping. Dooley tries to stop him and he thrashes Dooley. I run out to find help. When I come back, the man's lying dead and there's Dooley holding a knife. Please don't arrest him.
I should return and find out about this.
I do seem to have a sufficient amount of evidence, but maybe Dooley will let on a little more. And then there'll be an inquiry. Okay, let's accuse.
Me? No!
Oh, no, 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 not so quickly. You have indeed solved this murder, according to the facts at hand. However, Artie, what advice would you give?
I would encourage you to look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances.
Of course.
Try again. Use your powers to peer more deeply and see what you can discover.
Sure. Now we got some additional clues. Okay. Inspect the whole body.
How would the murderer have done it?
Small feet, Wilkins body, bandana, overhanded strike, tail assailant. Okay.
Re-examine some of the clues more closely.
Warehouse, large footprints. So, the boys don't have large footprints.
Establish a motive.
The imprint of a large worker's boot. Okay, so this was done by an adult. Let's go look back at the knife. There's two sets of fingerprints, one child, one adult.
Try to establish a motive.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Because the kid knows about the other adult supposedly involved. Let's find the trail. Another footprint. Medium footprints. The imprint of a medium-sized worker's boot. The imprint is marked by pebbles of coal and coal dust, making it possible to follow the tracks.
examine some of the clues more closely.
Then you got the small feet. Let's ask Mr. Freems again. Let's ask about Wilkins.
Wilkins wasn't the type to beat the children. On the contrary, he was forever getting in fights, trying to stop that sort of thing.
Yeah. Okay, how about the bandana?
The fumes can be a bit much in the brewery. When the men work in there, they wear bandanas.
I didn't realize a brewery could smell so foul. What else can you tell about the workers?
They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
Okay. Now we continue on looking for more clues. Oh, look, there's some more prints. Oh, and you follow those tracks. Footprints have just opened up.
Re-examine some of the clues more closely.
Flecks of clove of coal. This way. Four footprints.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Okay, here we go. Another person. Taylor works in the coal yard, and there's more coal.
Me and Wilkins was working out here. We heard screaming. Wilkins went to see what it was about and never come back. I went to see for myself, and there he was, dead. I didn't stick around. Somebody might think I'd done it.
Okay. What do you know about the bandana?
The strange thing is, Wilkins weren't wearing no bandana when I was talking to him. Only the workmen in the brewery wear bandanas. You should talk to Morris there.
Brewery entrance and the warehouse. Brewery cigarettes. Stubbed out cigarette butts.
I should go back and ask about this.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Large footprint. The imprint of a large worker's boot. Morris.
I don't much know who smokes here. Maybe Taylor. Cigarette might be his. Well, I was inside the brewery all day. I wear me bandana in there. Man has to, what with all the smells and fumes.
I didn't realize breweries would smell so bad. Because maybe to somebody who is not fond of drinking beer or alcohol, I guess.
Quit smoking months ago. You know, I saw somebody from the brewery having a smoke this morning. Didn't see who it was, though. Me and Wilkins was working out here. We heard screaming. Wilkins went to see what it was about and never come back.
To establish a motive.
Well, I was inside the brewery all day. I wear me bandana in there. Man has to, what with all the smells and fumes. Well, I was inside the brewery all day. I wear me bandana in there. Man has to, what with all the smells and fumes. Well, like I said, I was inside. Didn't get a chance to come out to smoke. Colton left, though. You can talk to him. He's working in the loading area just now.
Somebody named Colton. You can now make an accusation or continue investigation. Well, continue investigation. Going to the loading area. Colton works in brewery and loading area.
Well, I was having a chat with one of the others when I heard a commotion and ran in there to find Wilkins dead. Poor bloke, killed by that filthy little bastard that we feed and pay. I don't smoke, never did.
Need to find another clue. Here we go. Cigarette stubbed out.
Well, now, I didn't ask about this.
Try to establish a motive.
Oh, very well. So I do smoke now and then. What's the matter? Well, I was having a chat with one of the others when I heard a commotion and ran in there to find Wilkins dead. Poor bloke. Killed by that filthy little bastard that we feed and pay.
Now, this is gonna be hard to accuse. So we need to look at the evidence. There is some duplicity. At least one person lied. So we just accuse the adults. Like, who has motive? Okay, here's some more clues.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Just one clue I'm missing. Let's look at the knife again.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
But it's definitely not the kids.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Maybe need to ask about the shoes. Shoes need to be factored in. Oh yeah, footprints.
Me and Wilkins was working out here. We heard screaming. Wilkins went to see what it was about and never come back. I went to see for myself, and there he was, dead. I didn't stick around. Somebody might think I'd done it.
Check your case file to refresh your memory.
So, let's look at the bandana obscures the victim's face. Medium footprint. The imprint of a medium-sized worker boot. The imprint is marked by pebbles and coal dust, making it possible to follow the track. So it's done with medium footprints. The knife. Large footprint. Cigarettes. Large footprint. Blown area, stubbed out cigarette butts. Colton. Admits to smoking. Claims he doesn't smoke, so he did lie already. Claims he was talking to someone when he heard a commotion. Talking to someone. Ran to find Wilkins dead. He was too busy to smoke today. So, was committed by somebody who was smoking. So, it's between Morris and Colton, I think. Says he no longer smokes. Guesses the cigarettes might belong to him.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Like I said, I was inside. Didn't get a chance to come out to smoke. Colton left, though. You could talk to him.
Me and Wilkins was working out here. We heard screaming. Wilkins went to see what...
to establish a motive.
Tall, I think.
How would the murderer have done it?
I should return and find out about this. Well, I was having a chat with one of the others when I heard a commotion and ran in there to find Wilkins dead. Poor bloke, killed by that filthy little bastard that we feed and pay. Oh, very well. So I do smoke now and then. What's the matter?
I don't want to accuse this man. there's one missing clue. So in the warehouse, and there's a missing clue, so I need to go back to the warehouse.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
Okay, warehouse is this one.
Try to establish a motive.
Examine some of the clues more closely.
Okay, this is the warehouse, so there's one clue that I'm missing.
How would the murderer have done it?
That's Dooley's knife, all right. He never lent it to nobody. When I come back, the man's lying dead, and there's Dooley holding a knife. Please don't arrest him. I was standing there, having a think, when a fella come at me and give me a thumping. Dooley tries to stop him, and he thrashes Dooley. I run out to find help.
There's one piece of evidence I'm not touching.
He knocks me to the ground and give me a kick. I find my work knife under me and grab it. I lift my hands to protect myself, and he knocks me out with a punch. Later on, I wakes up, and the man's lying there, dead. He's my brother. He don't like to work hard, so one of the workers give him a thrashing. I tried to stop it, and he stops hitting Buck and starts hitting me.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
I don't have a motive.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him? would the murderer have done it? Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
I wonder if someone can tell me more about this.
Try to establish a motive.
Here we go. Here's some evidence. Letter. It has come to our attention that one of your workmen, a certain Mr. Colton, has been beating the child laborers. Our society finds this to be a matter of concern, as do you, no doubt. Please take action to curtail the practice. Miss Clara O'Day. Ah! Now we need to go back to talk to Colton. I'm gonna have to accuse Colton.
Which suspects had the opportunity to kill him?
Okay, that's Morris, so that's not him. So now we got the crucial piece of evidence that all I knew was Colton, but all evidence points to Colton, except for the knife, maybe. But then he accuses the boy of killing Wilkins, so which just means say that he's probably trying to set the kid up. Let's go right to it. We need to go right to the loading area. We need to make the activation now. Fine. Bolt. So we need to go to the loading area. Okay, right over there.
Look for more clues.
Okay. All right. Come clean, Colt. You already lied, so we're gonna flat out accuse you.
I should be foreman here. Wilkins coddled the boys like a mother hen. He come along and stops me giving the boys a beating.
We got him.
That was much more difficult than it initially appeared. Well done.
Now they're taking him in to arrest him.
Up to the clink with you!
An altercation between a boy and a workman ends in the death of the workman. The boy remembers lifting a knife, but not the actual killing. Did he do it? No. In fact, the dead worker, one John Wilkins, heard screams and ran to offer assistance. Once there, he found the boy unconscious and another workman, Tom Colton, standing unharmed. But Colton, long angry with Wilkins, thought fast and stabbed the man with the boy's knife. He then put his own bandana over Wilkins' face. Quick thinking, however, did not win out. Colton has been unmasked as the murderer. Henry Raymond. solve my first dreadful crime. Yep, 1,000 pounds, 800 experience points, and country cloak cake. Continue. Let's break this move. So that's my first dreadful crime. Put that on. Yeah. I'm gonna switch to you. Go solve another case. I just solved my first dreadful crime.
careless look on them. Case code. The case of the conflicted courtship. The reward is £1,500 and 800 Vithians. Geronimo!
Come take a look at what I've managed to conjure up today! There must be something of...
Oh. Be back later.
Leaving empty-handed? Pity.
I almost feel guilty when I don't find. Well, let's go quickly hide that.
Open fire!
Let's see how warm your innards are.
Doing a cargo hijack, a little break in the action. Sucker.
There you go.
to no good.
Gang war.
Serves you bloody well right.
I think this one took a shot at me once. Oh, serves you right.
Better you than me.
I'll find out where you're buried. Those are all grave.
Crying out loud. What's that again?
Won't bite that now, will you?
Now I'm gonna continue on with another. But just like before, we're gonna fast travel. Be right back. Thank you. Okay, I'm back. Hi, I'm Kill the Vid. Once again, this is the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, and I'm doing a Let's Play classic of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. To recap, I had already completed the main story mission, and I'm doing the DLC. This one in particular is the Dreadful Crimes, and I just saw one of the Dreadful Crimes, which was a murder that took place at a factory or brewery where a child was, where there was like a child involving a child. There was a murder in which the child was believed to be a suspect, but it was actually a worker that murdered the foreman. So I saw that without the false accusations, and it turns out the boy was innocent. So I'm very thankful for that, and I'm about to do another dreadful crime in this stream. I don't know how many dreadful crimes are in this DLC. If I knocked them all out in one episode, great. If not, great. So let's continue on, shall we? This is the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Here we go. Geronimo! So with Evie, she has a special cloaking ability. Where Jacob's special ability is, I forgot. But they're unique to the twins. Abbott's Cocoa. There's the Union Jack. Thank you.
Here, you might need this.
A case of the conflicted courtship. Solve the perplexing murder of a woman in a public park. Potential rewards: 1,500 pounds, 850 XP.
Tragedy in the park.
Another chance to sort out a diabolical conundrum. One that I'll turn into a one-a-penny read for Purlock Publishing.
So, we're back at it again. This time to investigate the murder of a woman. The victim is a Prudence Brown. Piss off.
Look at me. I'm sorry. Why would you want to
Whatever
kill
me? Whatever I did to deserve this, I'm so very sorry.
My God, thank you. This restores some of my faith in humanity.
Back, please. Stand back. There's no coming through here.
I'm going to enter through the other way. Here's the victim. The park. Prudence Brown, a young woman with identifying papers, stabbed many times in highly violent manner. Wounds indicate a left-handed attacker.
a left-handed attack. Okay, let's look at the other stuff. Stabbed. Brutally. Left-hand attacker. What we got here?
Packet.
A small paper packet containing powdered medication. Stamped, Dr. Trevor Alton with an address.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
Oh, bloodstain. Blood spatter. Like the body was dragged. Oh, there's the murder weapon. Found the murder weapon. Knife. The bloody murder weapon. It is a standard kitchen knife. Kitchen knife? It must have been done to somebody close to home. Like a husband or somebody. Left hand attacker. Check him out. What's his first?
Opening fire on him!
Yeah, cool.
Handbag contains an appointment diary. 10 a.m. Trevor Hawk. Noon. Gilbert. His house. The address is indicated in the back of the agenda.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
Make sure we get everything in the park. So now, we're gonna go see the good doctor. And Gilbert's house. Oh, look. Has nothing to do with the case, but just a hidden gem in the game. Blood trail.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Yeah.
Here now.
This path won't end well for you, mate.
Wall there. Oh. Atta girl.
I'm gonna stop off at the doctor's.
Come on.
I don't know any of Dr. Alton's other patients.
Dr. Alton's office. Doctor's note. Dear Miss Knight, I would ask you to please suspend Mr. Shelby's prescription. This note, as well as all medical entries in the office, appeared to be written by a right-handed man.
I'm sorry to hear about her murder. She was a patient here, but increasingly began to stop by socially.
Can you tell us about the park meeting?
So she was meeting Dr. Alton in the park, was she? My understanding was that she was engaged to someone. In any case, the good doctor could do better, in my opinion. Perhaps now he will.
Dr. Alton's office. Prudence's medical file. Miss Brown came to see me, oppressed by grave anxiety concerning her recent engagement. This was not a medical concern, but nevertheless, I prescribed a mild sedative. However, she has since embarked on an irregular relationship with someone I shall not name. This situation is intolerable. Another doctor's note. Mr. Shelby's medical file. Since using this treatment, Mr. Shelby has overcome his paralyzing timidity with astonishing success. However, owing to the effects I've seen of the same drug on Mr. Baxter, I feel obliged to terminate Mr. Shelby's use altogether.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
Mr. Shelby, paralyzing timidity, stopped treatment, right-handed. Need to interrogate him again. But first, I need to get upstairs. I think there's a second, third floor.
Oh my God, Prudence! How horrible! I was about to propose. But I don't understand. She and I didn't have a meeting arranged today. It is true that we sometimes meet in the park, but there was no arrangement for this morning. That's very odd indeed. Prudence was a patient here, but wasn't given this prescription. There's no reason that she should be carrying such a packet.
There's two more clues in this area. Personal note. Doctor, I do not hope that our professional relationship does not preclude a closer rapport. Yours most sincerely, Miss Clara Knight. Baxter's medical file. Baxter now appears to be totally reliant on the treatment. He consumes far more than the prescribed dosage and is constantly demanding more. In addition, he has become alarmingly aggressive, going so far as to assault me physically. Furthermore, he has recklessly seduced several women over the past few weeks.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
An unfortunate incident. One of my patients became overexcited. You appreciate, I'm sure, that I cannot discuss the condition of any of my patients.
Jumped out the window unexpectedly, but that's funny. Oh.
I fart in church or something?
Never used to see things like that.
To take
name
shame.
No offense to me.
Back into that. Got another bone to pick with you, Shelby.
I'm quite angry, actually. I was having such terrific results. I felt like a new man. Much more vigorous and outgoing. But the doctor has ended the prescription altogether for no reason.
Baxter apparently attacked the doctor yesterday. It was after hours, but the doctor did have a cut on his cheek. Poor man. Dr. Alton makes house calls to see him. Baxter doesn't come into the office. I make up the prescriptions and he picks them up at noon when I'm away at lunch.
Prudence has been so distant lately. I believe she has a misplaced affection for her doctor, the cat. I would make a much more appropriate husband, and the wedding is planned. Prudence has been so distant lately. I believe she has a misplaced affection for her doctor, the cat. I would make a much more appropriate husband, and the wedding is planned. Prudence and I are engaged to be married. I'm desperate to see her. She should be by any moment. She had something important to tell me. I'm worried she's going to break off the engagement.
Possible suspect. Letter from Prudence. Dearest Gilbert, I have something of the utmost importance to tell you. I shall call tomorrow at noon. Please, dear Gilbert, I know whatever I have to say, I will always hold you in the highest esteem. Your Prudence. The letterhead gives Prudence his address.
Yeah.
Prudence's house. So there's two clues, one suspect. Prudence's house. Prudence's diary. Several entries stand out. I hold Gilbert in the greatest esteem, but I simply cannot imagine marriage at all entails, and all it entails. I've seen so little of the world. I have begun to see a doctor in an attempt to calm my nerves and concentrate my mind. Dr. Alton is kind and gentle, and the solicitous manner with which he listens is as beneficial as any medication. Oh, what a rapturous night. The timid Dr. Trevor Alton has surprising depths. We had a chance encounter in the park, whereupon he began to speak to me with such intensity and passion. So it was an affair. I was quite sweat up. Soon his ardent kisses took my breath away. Could it be that I have found love at last? And what, then, of my engagement to Gilbert? My feelings for Trevor, it seems so silly to call him Dr. Alton now, are as strong as ever, but mixed with concern. He has become moody, even tormented. He complains of his experimental treatment and of his patients. I have told him that I plan to break things off with Gilbert. Trevor and I are to meet in the park this morning. Is a proposal in the offing? If he does propose, oh, please let it be so. I shall go directly to Gilbert and break it off with him. A swift, sharp break is best for everyone. There's another clue to find. Oh, there's a clue right there. Unsent letter to Dr. Alton. Dearest Trevor, I must tell you that this evening something unsettling occurred. After our tete-a-tete in the park, I set off for home, all the while thinking of you. But suddenly a young woman appeared and began to berate me in the street, never ceasing to shout insults and shameful allegations involving someone named Baxter. Isn't that the patient you had such trouble with? Oh, my dear, I managed to slip away, but it was so terribly upsetting. But now, I see it is too late to post this, and I will see you tomorrow in any case, my love. So it seems to be an affair of the heart that probably turned into a crime of passion.
I saw her kissing my man in the park, didn't I? I followed her to this street yesterday, but lost her. I'll come every day if need be, until I catch her again. That trollop better promise to let him alone, or I'll give her what for. He's all mine, I tell you. All the girls want a bit of Baxter, but they can't have him. You ask him yourself, he lives just that way.
All locations unlocked. Man, they ain't trying to accuse nobody. Let's go to back.
You're trespassing!
Be quiet. You're obstructing an investigation. A murder investigation.
Gosh, perfect.
Come here, you little rat. Get back here, you little rat. Stop, you little rat.
Give me that. If you're hungry, find Clara O'Day and tell her Evie sent you.
Will do.
That was violate. Rod. That's odd. I didn't think an NPC would be up this high. Scattered papers. I always get what I want. It is my due. Written by a left-handed man. Baxter has left hand. His left hand. That's another clue. But all points might lead to Baxter. She means nothing to you. You are a monster of my own making. Written by a right-handed man. She plans to break her engagement. Because of you, I won't have it. I shall marry her myself. At least, that way she will remain a respectable woman. Written by a right-handed man. Oh, there's a knife there. You are nothing but a burden to me. A pathetic, sniveling burden. If only I could be rid of you. Written by a left-handed man. Paper packets. Many empty paper packets. They have a residue of powder on them.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
So I got two more clues in this area. Oh, look. A knife. Collection of kitchen knives identical to the one found on the crime scene. One is missing, so it's definitely Baxter. More than likely, it's Baxter. The murderer, other than him, might have taken the knife from here and killed it just to throw off the track. Just to throw off the scent. says here. I can't extinguish your life, so I shall extinguish hers. Written by a left-handed man, there is a spot of blood. Blood on the note. I think we need to go back to the office. So it's the last, we're actually in the last 25 minutes of the stream. It looks like I'm probably gonna solve two back-to-back cases for the dreadful crimes. We need to go back to the doctor's office.
There you are. There you go. Here now.
Okay.
Faster! Atta girl. Easy. Dr. Alton makes house calls to see him. Baxter doesn't come into the office. I make up the prescriptions and he picks them up at noon when I'm away at lunch. Mr. Baxter apparently attacked the doctor yesterday. It was after hours, but the doctor did have a cut on his cheek. Poor man. That medicine was developed by Dr. Alton specifically for one of our patients, Mr. Shelby. But he's been using it for another patient as well.
Gilbert Higgins.
Prudence has been so distant lately. I believe she has a misplaced affection for her doctor, the cat. I would make a much more appropriate husband, and the wedding is planned. I've never heard of such a man. Prudence and I are engaged to be married. I'm desperate to see her. She should be by any moment. She had something important to tell me. I'm worried she's going to break off the engagement.
So I need to find Baxter. I think Baxter's the guy. Last 14 minutes of the stream. Thank you.
Bottle.
Last 10 minutes. 8 minutes.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect. Slowly now. Easy, girl. That's it. Calm. Me.
That's very odd indeed. Prudence was a patient here, but wasn't given this prescription. This... You appreciate, I'm sure, that I cannot discuss the condition of any of my patients.
I'm about to get ready to close this.
And that's going to be doing it for this edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate. The Dreadful Crimes DLC on the 9 to 5 Outlaw does gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. At about 10 p.m. Eastern, I'm going to be doing another Let's Play of Sleeping Dogs Definitive Edition, featuring the episodic content, Year of the Snake. Look for that tonight. Until then, I'm Kill the Vid for the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, and please, stay safe.